even though it's an orange, it doesn't come up very much on my skin. That's why I want to use this.
Right.
A pinkish one.
Okay, but you can't use it. What you're using, the which shirt you're using?
I think we're sticking with this one.
Okay, well then you can't use orange in there.
Really?
That's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. You're gonna be fashion. Think of your color. Think of your color theory.
Yeah.
Right? You're leaning more towards the blues and more towards the purple. Mm-hmm. Think of where orange is compared to that. I mean, it's way across the other side. You're gonna offset your tones if you do that.
Okay.
Unless you were doing something specifically funky for color. But if you're going evening, stay within that particular palette.
Okay.
Right?
So this is gonna be kind of your base color.
All right, well, if I was you, the pink that you have there,
I'm just using a little bit.
Okay. All right. Okay. We'll try it. I mean, it doesn't hurt. I mean, you know, if you don't like it when you finish, you could always
take it off.
Yeah. To enhance that a little bit, and remember that because you have a brow bone, when you're putting in your smokiness, remember to take the flat of the brush and press it up onto the brow bone like that, so that you get it feathering going right across your arm. Okay? Because remember, a smoky eye is not to look as if somebody hit you in the eye. Okay? So you gotta be careful with that. November session, and all of you look glam. So
fabulous.
Yeah, fabulous. Yeah. So it's like, you know, just kind of want to have a few minutes and have y'all tell me and tell the audience, you know, what was your experience like? Would you do it again? What have you learned? You know, is it worth it?
I've learned a lot with the foundation and the blush and all that. Like, I never used to go in here. I obviously like put on powder.
Uh-huh.
And the difference is so big that if you actually take the time to do everything that asks, you need to learn that.
Yes.
I second that. Because the judges saw your holder, that wasn't even the right
color. And we wouldn't say how much you paid for it.
And then felt on a little color just to match what we were in, and thought that was it, and then really permanent.
Yes, those angular things,
yes,
that you finally have gotten rid of because you're not,
yes,
seeing them anymore.
Exactly, yeah. I've learned to blend. Contour. Yes. And switch from day to evening. And your lipstick.
Red lipstick. That's cool.
Find one of the key things I learned was that we need to get away from matching the whole eyeshadow to the top. But I find I was guilty of that. A lot of people I know are guilty of that. And so it has increased my awareness as to what might work, what might not work, and just help me to more experiment with my own personal style.
Yes. Irrespective of the time of the day. And the early morning.
At the 4 o'clock in the morning.
4 o'clock in the morning. Right.
Like,
so,
Judith said, experimentation is one of the things I kind of learned, to have a little more confidence and try to put on a little, just step up your color, step up your look a little more, like before lip balm, and that's it, and I'm going to work like that. But now I've been experimenting with using color for work as well. So I think it's been a great experience. It's something I would do again. It's been a lot of fun.
It's cool.
Well, for me, besides everything else that everybody has said, I've learned some basic stuff, like in terms of driving, I usually drive my window down, and I was having breakouts on the right side of my face. And then only after coming to class, I realized that that's from not wearing any powder or foundation to protect my face, and then all the dust and stuff in the road. And then since then, I was not having as much breakouts. Then I learned to blend as well, wear lipstick and wear foundation the evening. And it's a lot of fun.
Concealer?
Yes, and concealer. I own the concealer, but I didn't know what to do with it until I come to class. So.
Yeah. That's really cool.
Because if you know why you're doing something, it makes it that much easier to do it. I mean, you're not just being robotic. Because if you're being robotic and you forget a step, you don't know how to change it to go to the next step. Or if you're just told, well, use A, B, C, and you must have this color, this color, this color, when a color runs out, what are you going to do? You know, you're not going to be able to be flexible and to be able to adapt. So I'm glad that you've enjoyed it. I can see that it's been a lot of fun for all of you. I'm doing this to be able to create a network of ladies who just want to be able to be strong and empowered, because whether you realize it or not, I mean, you're wearing makeup, and when you wear makeup with a certain level of confidence. As I told you before, if you are going to buy a palette with 40 colors in it, it makes no sense only using two. You've wasted your money. But if you're going to wear color, be expected to be seen. But you do not want to land on certain media blogs.
Hi, I'm Tams. Always wash your brushes.
Hello, I'm Shade, and you should not have makeup for over a year.
Hi, my name is Latoya. You should never go to sleep in your makeup. A $3 store is your friend. Invest in the products, baby wipes.
Hi, I'm Judith. Remember to moisturize your face.
Hi, I'm Lisa. Don't be afraid to experiment with colors, and don't forget, make sure your moisturizer has an SPF. Facing it goes so far, so gone, that you lose a post. The night is almost gone. Let's put our cool shades on. Let's smoke, let's dance, let's pop. Three or four, we got them blazing lights flashing everywhere. Girl, let down your hair. Yeah.